little bit of movement. Oh, just bouncing before Jones, and that'll be three runs for Sri Lanka to get them off to a decent start. Flicked away, a low full toss, beautifully timed from Atapattu. First boundary off the bat, and it's crisply struck. Flayed away, and Atapattu stands and admires it, doesn't even bother running. Glorious cover drive. That's a little bit better. That'll make her feel much brighter about life. And exactly what you were saying, it's nice when they do that, Katie George. Much better flow of the bat down the ground for Sanjuani than the previous ball.
Good reply there from Gaur, the bouncer. I think she's actually been working slightly on that bouncer over the summer.
Driving the ball into the surface produces that absolute jaffa. Sri Lanka's main threat has been undone by a glorious piece of bowling from Mahika Gaur.
And that's as good as it gets, isn't it, Daggers? I think, you know, Atapattu, she was looking to sort of settle in there, but Mahika, she's bowled that wide and then immediately corrected. And
another glorious piece of bowling from Mahika Gaur. What a dream debut for England this is. Once more, it's a superb piece of left arm swing.
We've seen two perfect deliveries from Mahika Gaur there, one to the left-hander, one to the right-hander, tempting her into that drive and going through the gate, middle stump gone.
Nicely played down the ground, just over pitching on that occasion. Kate Cross just timed, not a huge amount of power, but enough to race away to the boundary. So 10 overs gone, end of the power play. Positioned herself in there. That's a good shout and given. You can see that had a lot going for it. Sarah Glenn into the attack, and she gets her first of the day.
Naratna, it's ball going straight on. And if you get your pads a little bit offside of the ball, the bat has to come across the line.
Oh, nicely played. Made it nice and late. Just worked the blade and tickled fine enough to race away to the boundary.
Lauren Violet, with that extra bit of pace and the natural way that she would spear the ball across the lefties, might be a real weapon for them.
More of an enforcer.
Cue the wide half volley. Apart from that particular delivery. Big appeal, but Lauren Filer not as animated as Amy Jones behind the stump.
So original decision is not out. Pitching in line, impact is in line. Wickets missing. Go back on field to Sue, stay with your decision of not out.
Big appeal this time and given. Just a little flick behind. And the pace of Lauren Filer.
Against Australia, a little bit of extra pace and bounce climbing on Hassini Pereira. Just a feather, she didn't even bother to review. She knew it.
Just well enough, it was in the air for a little while. Decent sized boundaries here, and a boundary to finish the over. There you go, that's what you're going to get from Lauren Filer, and I have no problem with that at this stage in her career. She is going to bowl short and wide. She is going to bowl full and wide. That was a real gift. 74 for four. Edged and taken. Well, the short ball has worked on a couple of occasions now. Lauren Filer making another important breakthrough. Five down now.
persistence pays off. Short, just climbing a little bit. Smartly taking catch as well. And England have found a gem. Found a couple today.
Edged and gone, first ball. Staying slightly leg side of the ball, and Lauren Filer is on a hat-trick.
I've not been witness to this sort of pace. Filer has it, paying dividends for England.
Worth the try.
It's obvious they're just not very comfortable against this pace from Filer.
That was a real gift.
Oh, nicely played. Nicely played again. That's why I think the angle from over the wicket is better for Filer. There a tickle. Amy Jones certainly thought she heard something. Looked as though there was a gap between the ball and the bat to me, but we'll find out if they decide to go upstairs.
Okay, the ball's passed close to the bat. I'd like to take a look at Ultra Edge when it's ready, please. Okay, Ultra Edge coming up. So flat line before the bat. Keep playing it through. Keep playing it through. Okay, so there is a spike as the ball is next to the bat. Your on-screen signal now.
Well, a wry smile on the face of James Middlebrook. A wry one on my face as well, because that is an excellent review from England. Oh, that's out. That is out. Sue Redmond raises the finger. Amy Jones holds on again behind the stump. She rarely misses anything. A situation for Sri Lanka.
Another great take by Amy Jones there behind the stumps, but I think, you know, Sarah Glenn's toiled away there and she deserves that wicket.
Yay!
Gone! And the stump just manages to come out of the hole and end up on the ground. Sarah Glenn with 3 foot.
And a third wicket, and a wonderful day, and a wonderful England debut for Mahika Gaur. Just nipping back round the wicket, through the gate. And Sri Lanka, 106 all out.
And here's a full interval. Heather Knight will be told about that, I'm sure. That's what we've been told anyway. Top of leg stump, not top of off stump, either way. Brilliant length, and she's got the ball moving laterally in the air, and when the ball has stopped moving in the air,
batting together that well, slightly short and pulled away by Emma Lamb. Generally pretty good against the short ball, picks it up nicely. Oh, like buses, they're all coming at once now. Short delivery previously, this one full and wide and nicely dealt with by Emma Lamb. England 23 without loss. Oh, that's what Tammy Beaumont had been searching for a while, just rocking on to the back foot. Nicely weighted. Excellent timing. Oh, she's managed to work that one away. A low full toss, poor delivery really. Dealt with nicely by Beaumont.
Crashed away. Don't bowl there, Tammy Beaumont. Unerringly, that will be the result. That is an incentive to keep drilling it down the ground and improving that strike rate. Then I don't know what is. Brilliance from Beaumont. Oh, shot. Too easy. has been played with grace and power through extra cover off the back foot. 50 up for England.
Yeah.
Gap found once again. Jimmy Beaumont not lost any of that timing. And she has. Would you believe it? Not quite a magic trick, but that angle, low arm, ball arcing into Tammy Beaumont. From Pereira at slip.
It was the closest, you called it, Butch. Great that there was a slip in place to be able to snaffle it. Just a little bit too close to cut, the angle too acute.
Oh, shot. Creamed through the covers by Heather Knight. It's a beauty. Up and into the hands of mid-off, surely, yes. Emma Lamb with a really tame end to what has been a good inning so far. Mid-off was left up. Rana Singha invited the stroke.
Well, a timely wicket for Sri Lanka in more ways than one. Just not quite to it. Toe end of the bat. Looping up.
With strokes a little bit like that. Glorious off drive to open her account.
Lovely timing. She was hitting the ball. Again there, beautiful timing. Lovely shot. Deep point went back. Deep point needs to go and pick it up because it was dragged down with enough width.
Has that come off the back of the bat or the glove? I think James Middlebrook thinks it has. Heather Knight, I think, reckons that she probably has as well.
Like it's just gone off her gloves there. I think if I lip read Heather Knight walking off, she said it was a bit weird how that's happened, but yeah, one of those things. Yeah, as we just look there, it's just had a little punch off the gloves into the keeper's hands.
Well, a bit of a mix up with the calling, but it doesn't matter because that is streaking away to the boundary. And Maya Bouchier, in her first performance and appearance as a one-day international cricketer for England. As is Chamari Attapattu, that'll race away. Always a very quick outfield, short boundaries here at the county ground. Now that is magnificent, the very best of Chamari Attapattu. Slapped away through cover. Well played. Maybe a little bit off the toe end of the bat. Yeah, Anna Harris vociferous in her decision making. There were two noises. I think the first noise was the bat of Gunaratne hitting her front pad.
Yep, so clear gap between bat and ball. Keep playing through. Ball has passed gloves and bats. Satisfied there is no bat or glove involved. Back to Anna on field, please.
Anna Harris, as she so often is. She gets a weight into that one all right, though. It's a long half volley. Is there any other kind? And it has been dealt with by Gunaratne. Slapped away, uppish, but hit ferociously hard through the covers. because every time she gets wide of off stump, that's the result. Off to delivery, yes. Kate Cross finally gets the chance to bowl at a right-hander, and immediately she makes the breakthrough.
It's fantastic bowling from Cross. That length is perfect. Groping for the ball there.
Crunched again. That extra cover drive is working exceptionally well.
Excellent piece of bowling from Lauren Filer, just drawing in the outside edge. Comfortable catch for Amy Jones and England. They have their second.
This is not a half volley. It's just short of one, but the tentative forward push, just waving the bat along the line of the ball, and that is excellent.
Well, up and over the top at a Patu. No mucking about today. Manages to find the boundary with ease. And again, this time slightly fuller, but slightly longer from Atapattu. First maximum of the day. That's a good shot. It's just gone on with the arm. Atapattu caught on the crease. She's reviewed it straight away. Charlie Dean, not just this delivery, but the setup as well. It's just gone on with the arm. Jamari Atapattu stuck on the crease, expecting some turn.
Okay, original decision is out. Pitching is in line, impact is in line, and wickets are hitting. So back on field to Anna, please.
No, I don't think we can underestimate how much of...
Edged and taken. Straightforward catch in the deep, Sarah Glenn. Just mixed up her length a little bit. It's generally been the length, and this time the shorter ball has worked.
As if to say, yep, that's the plan. And we have executed it to perfection. Karuna Ratney unable to get inside the line of that so she could keep it down. Sarah Glenn.
So, in effect, that there is the line. Not quite. It went quickly, slip in place, but skipper can't cling on. Some will turn and some won't. And that one just slid on.
Went very quickly to Heather Knight. Plenty of revs, bit of drop. Duhari thought she was going to be able to cover that and push it into the cover.
So good for the off spinner, outside off stump. That is taken. Simple as you like. Again, line, but also flight on this occasion. Charlie Dean in the wickets.
Atapattu with one that went on with the arm. This is just much slower. Watch the drop on that. Again, Duhari thinks she's got to the pitch of it, tries to push it down the ground, but it drops and hits high up on the bat, and Charlie Dean.
Variation up a little easy. Oh, gone, dragged on. Ranka now in a little bit of trouble, in fact, a lot of trouble. Wickets are beginning to tumble here.
Bit of a mid-inning specialist with the ball. Cross-seam delivery, it just grips a tiny bit. Sanjuani with the bat coming down from gully.
Oh, cut away and dropped. Lauren Filer banging it in. Cut to Tammy Beaumont there at point.
Well, you'd expect it. It was coming hard. It was a decent height for Tammy Beaumont.
Big appeal. And the finger goes up. Sarah Glenn. We said round the wickets, bringing the stumps in play. She goes for the review.
Yeah, the ball is close to the gloves and the bats. We'll need to check with Ultra Edge, please. Thank you. Okay, original decision is out. Pitching is outside off. Impact is in line. And wickets are umpire's call. So back to Jazz on field, please. Signal out now, please. Thank you.
Sue Redfern, the TV umpire, confirms.
Yeah!
Oh, nicely again from Lauren Filer, and the combination of her and Amy Jones strikes again. Sri Lanka really are in all sorts of bother there now, eight down.
Rabidani did not want to get in line. You can see that she was offering the stumps. Very similar dismissal to up in Durham.
Was alert to a possible run out situation.
They batted for 30.2 overs, 106, so just 106 for 9 here. Poor cricket, really poor cricket. Excellent from Kate Cross. Great awareness from Kate Cross.
Yeah, just play that back for me, please, director. Just go back again. Yeah, and play forward. Just play all the way forward, full speed. Thank you. There is nothing grounded. I am ready to make my decision. Thank you.
Nicked, yeah! And gone, straight to that slip. Kulasiriya pitching the ball up, getting it to swing, and that is a huge wicket for Sri Lanka.
Taking a simple catch in slip, and Tammy Beaumont just advancing and looking to go into the leg side against the swing. It's really nice delivery.
Oh, that's been smoked. It should go all the way. Long levers from Maya Bouchier. That came right out of the middle of the bat.
A little punch. It's gone a long way over the boundary. That's a really good pickup. Great connection.
That's a sweet shot.
Yeah, needed
stopping. Needed the dive to come off. And that's high class from Capsi. Oh, and gone. What a beauty from Prabhadani.
Lines and lengths that Sri Lanka have bowled. Alice Capsi just going back to a foolish delivery. Just nips off the seam. Sri Lanka get their reward for toiling away.
Bouchier just keeps the blade open long enough to feed it between extra cover and mid-off.
Over the infield.
Which Maya Bouchier does. Doesn't get all of it, but it skids off the advertising mat and brings up another boundary.
Oh, nicely timed. So strong off the back foot. Nat Sciver-Brunt doesn't need a huge amount of length to climb into it.
Look how she uses the depth of that crease as well. Plays it right under the eye line. Doesn't try and overhit it. She's just trying to pick the gap. Well, she does. With it.
Well, again, nicely timed. Manages to split the two out in the deep. So Nat Sciver-Brunt really getting into her work now. Well, that's the best of them all. We've seen a couple off the back foot from Nat Sciver-Brunt. This time, she's saying, I'm going downtown.
Again, we saw the depth of the crease used. This time, it's the shuffle, and that is flush. Right out of the middle from Sciver-Brunt. And this one, I really like this. She's giving the spinners something to think about here. Sri Lanka's spinners have been pretty dominant over the course of this.
And again, she's managed to work it through with ease. Nat Sciver-Brunt really is. And again, has she managed to find the gap? Yes, she has. Nat Sciver-Brunt. That's a freebie. Maya Bouchier deals with it nicely, just helps the ball on its way. Well, that came right out of the screws. Maya Bouchier making the most of that free hit, and again goes all the way. Her second six of the day. No, is that an England A side also going out there again. Nicely timed by Nat Sciver-Brunt. We've seen a few of those today.
That gap at mid-wicket is being... it needs a little bit more help on the leg side, but that is a wonderful innings, a half century 51. From just 38 deliveries in testing conditions with the ball moving around.
Well, it's a splendid innings by a fantastic cricketer. Nat Sciver-Brunt has broken the record for England's fastest ODI 100.
She's going to do neither.
Yeah, she's been magnificent, Daggers.
Belinda Clark, the other six.
Alan!
And Sheld. And you just get that sense, Lauren Winfield Hill. Six overs upcoming.
Yeah, Alan! Another chance goes begging. Saw a cat.
Catch it!
Shouts a catch. Fallen short. Oh, there's been chances. That one was difficult. Coming quickly.
Falling short, the trajectory that Nat Sciver hit it.
Another opportunity maybe. And finally, Sri Lanka managed to hold on to one. And it brings to a close what has been a superb display of power hitting. Hammered away from Amy Jones. It could be the end of it, and is. Second wicket for Dilhari.
Amy Jones just advancing down and just lost control of the bat face. Got a little slice. And it's a good catch.
Right across the line. That will go all the way from Bess Heath. And that's what she is capable of, what she has been brought into the side to do. Oh, well run. Oh, I tell you what, this could be close, you know. I wonder if... Because Alice Davidson-Richards didn't slide her bat in. And they're going to take a look at this.
Roll it through, ball is in the hand. Keep rolling. Freeze it there. The batter has not made the ground. I'm ready for my decision for the big screen.
Full toss. Cross the line. Could be her downfall, and is. Almost good enough from Bess Heath. Prabhadani interested. Charlie Dean just trying to work it around. Not quite sure if there was a little bit of bat on there, perhaps.
Original decision is not out. It's pitching outside leg. I'm ready to go back.
Relatively easy. And the correct decision from James Middlebrook.
Any sort of pressure. And on that, we've got a dot ball.
Anyway, last ball. And it won't be a dot, it'll be at least one. And maybe a run out. Should be a run out, is a run out. Sarah Glenn selflessly sacrificing herself for the cause of trying to get an extra run.
Oh, Todd Hedge flies over the head of Amy Jones and Nat Sciver. Keeper and slip respectively. When Amy Jones thinks there's a tickle. Mahika Gaur's running into a stiff breeze, so she might not have heard it if it was faint.
Yeah, roll it through for me. Keep rolling. It's a flat line. Keep rolling. I'm satisfied there's no bat. I'm ready to go back to Anna on field.
Anna Harris, quite right. With the naked eye, or semi-naked. Slap down the ground. And that is a shot of authority from Sanjuani. She might be getting some around chest height. Oh my goodness, emphatic. A sight that every fast bowler loves to see, and that is stumps lying on the ground and bales flying.
It's full, it's fast from Lauren Filer. She just clips the pads, rattles into the stumps.
Gone. Superb bowling. Beautifully taken by Alice Davison Richards at slip. That is high quality left arm swing bowling from Mahika Gaur.
A lovely shape from Mahika Gaur. It's full. Just swings away. It's a good low catch from Alice Davison Richards.
In the air, but through the gap. Yeah, angle was narrowed by Alice Capsey getting in tight, but the placement was perfect.
Straight through Lauren Filer. She's been drawing in the outside edge. Now she's gone straighter. Perhaps the extra pace has beaten Delaney, and they have their third.
But it was the length delivery, and that's actually what has been so impressive about Filer. Yes, the pace is there. The accuracy and the length that she's been bowling in the last week or so has been eye-catching there. Targeting the stumps, top of the stumps as well.
Well, not much hanging around for Atapattu after not scoring a run for half an hour. Charlie Dean is in on the action. And then Chamari Atapattu, perhaps reluctantly, is going to review it.
The ball is passing close to the bat. I'd like to confirm with Ultra Edge when ready. Yeah, original decision is out, pitching in line. Impact is in line. I'm ready to go back to James on field.
James Middlebrook getting it right and a lot going for it. So Chamari Atapattu on her way.
Oh, yeah. Chipped yeah. up and taken. Off her own bowling, very good, Charlie Dean. Something that you've just been mentioning, Mark Butcher, that ability for overspin. Maybe the batter's thinking that they've made it to the pitch of the ball, but actually, they're about a foot short. Gladly received.
Yeah, she's good, Charlie Dean. She really is. It's just wonderful to see a finger spinner get that much energy on the ball. Not looking just to fire it in and restrict scoring. Genuinely looking to take a wicket, wraps that finger up and over the ball.
ICC events. Ah! Oh, another one. Little feather, Hassini Pereira. And this is the thing about Charlie Dean, she gets good players out.
Yeah, heavier side spin this time. Pereira just finds her hands drawn towards the ball as it spins past.
That is absolute off-spinning perfection. Tossed it up, little drift away from the right-hander, turned back through the gate. Thanks very much. Three in the over for Dean.
It's Michael Vaughan about Sachin Tendulkar. Drop, little bit of drift, sharp turn. Batter again thinks they've got to the pitch a bit, but are miles away.
Yeah! Play Dom. Charlie Dean in the action, in with another wicket and a 5-wicket haul for Charlie Dean. She has been outstanding.
Lovely shape and control. Just a little bit of turn. Bit of assistance for Charlie Dean from the batter. Played off.
Setting things up nicely for the spinners to come in. And clean up, and again, Sarah Glenn this time in on the action. Her first wicket of the evening. And it's the ninth down now for Sri Lanka.
Yeah, the ball is passing close to the bat. I'd like to confirm with Ultra Edge when ready. Original decision is out. It's pitching in line, impact is in line, and wickets are hitting. I'm ready to go back to Anna on field.
All right, decision. Straight through. Change of angle has done the trick for Lauren Filer. It's also done the trick for England as they complete this ODI series with a win.
Congratulations to
and they
England
do it convincingly. They win by 161 runs.